Tired of life on Earth? We have some very interesting news that's especially for you, and it concerns the fact that scientists are a bunch of crazy heads who have recently discovered insane stuff. Have you ever considered the potential that a new planet could provide you with a shot at a better life? People regularly discuss the notion that there is a new planet out there, but have you ever given it any thought? Scientists in today's world have gone too far in terms of technology. Welcome back to the future space. The video is about to begin and is going to drive you insane. Therefore, you shouldn't skip the video just yet. Let's get down to business without wasting much more time. Together, Webb's huge mirror and its precise instruments were able to acquire the most exact measurements to date of starlight that has been filtered through the atmosphere of a planet that is not within our solar system. The light spectrum, which provides information about the composition of an atmosphere on a planet 1150 light years away, exhibits a clear trace of water. The significance of the role that Webb will play in the search for planets that might be able to support life in the years to come is hinted at by the strength of the signal that it has detected. Previous investigations of this planet did not find any signs of haze or clouds. Nevertheless, the powerful new picture from Webb has uncovered such evidence. The James Webb Space Telescope at NASA has acquired evidence of clouds and haze in the atmosphere around a hot, puffy gas giant planet that orbits a distant sun-like star. In addition, the JWST has captured the unmistakable signature of water in the atmosphere. The observation, which reveals the presence of specific gas molecules based on tiny decreases in the brightness of specific colors of light, is the most detailed of its kind to date. It demonstrates Webb's unprecedented ability to analyze atmospheres hundreds of light years away, which is a testament to the scope of Webb's capabilities. Webb's immediate and more detailed observation marks a giant leap forward in the quest to characterize potentially habitable planets beyond Earth. While the Hubble Space Telescope has analyzed numerous exoplanet atmospheres over the past two decades, capturing the first clear detection of water in 2013, Webb's observation marks a giant leap forward. One of the more than 5,000 exoplanets that have been confirmed to exist in the Milky Way is called WASP-96b. It is approximately 1,150 light-years away in the constellation Phoenix, which can be found in the southern sky. It is a type of gas giant that does not have a direct equivalent in our solar system. WASP-96b is substantially puffier than any other planet that orbits our Sun, while having a mass that is less than half that of Jupiter and a diameter that is 1.2 times greater. And with the temperature being higher than 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit, it is considerably hotter. The distance between WASP-96b and its Sun-like host star is only 1/9 of the gap that separates Mercury and the Sun, and the planet completes one circle around its host star every 3.5 Earth days. WASP-96b is a great target for atmospheric investigations due to its massive size, short orbital period, puffy atmosphere, and the absence of neighboring objects in the sky that emit light that could be contaminated by the light from other objects. On June 21, the near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph aboard the James Webb Space Telescope took readings of light coming from the WASP-96 system for 6.4 hours. This took place when the planet migrated in front of the star. The result is a transmission spectrum that shows how the brightness of various wavelengths of infrared light between 0.6 and 2.8 microns changed throughout the transit, as well as a light curve that displays the overall lowering of starlight that occurred during the transit. The transmission spectrum reveals previously hidden details of the atmosphere, including the unambiguous signature of water, indications of haze, and evidence of clouds that were thought not to exist based on prior observations. While the light curve confirms properties of the planet that had already been determined from other observations, such as the existence of the planet, its size, and its orbit, the transmission spectrum reveals previously hidden details of the atmosphere. It is possible to determine a planet's transmission spectrum by contrasting the starlight that has been filtered by a planet's atmosphere as it travels across a star with the starlight that has not been filtered and which is detected when the planet is near the star. Researchers can detect and measure the abundances of key gases in a planet's atmosphere based on the absorption pattern, which consists of the locations and heights of peaks on the graph. This allows for the detection and measurement of the abundance of critical gases. Atoms and molecules each have their unique pattern of wavelengths that they can absorb, much in the same way as individuals have their unique fingerprints and DNA sequences. The near-infrared transmission spectrum of WASP-96b that was captured by NIRAS is not only the most detailed near-infrared transmission spectrum of an exoplanet atmosphere that has been captured to date, but it also covers a remarkably wide range of wavelengths, including visible red light and a portion of the spectrum that has not previously been accessible from other telescopes. This spectrum was taken by NIRAS. This section of the spectrum is especially sensitive to water as well as other important compounds including oxygen, methane, and carbon dioxide. These molecules are not immediately apparent in the spectra of WASP-96b, but they should be observable in future exoplanets that Webb is planning to observe. Researchers will be able to utilize the spectrum to estimate the temperature of the atmosphere with depth, assess the amount of water vapor that is present in the atmosphere, and constrain the abundance of other elements, such as carbon and oxygen. When they have all of this knowledge, they can use it to conclude the planet's composition as a whole, as well as how, when, and where it came into existence. The blue line on the graph represents a model that provides the best fit to the data by taking into account the known properties of WASP-96b and its star, as well as the assumed characteristics of the atmosphere. This model can be found by following the blue line. Because of Webb's cutting-edge design, we can obtain the outstanding detail and clarity that are present in these measurements. It has a gold-coated mirror that is 270 square feet in size and is very effective at collecting infrared light. Light is dispersed into rainbows of tens of thousands of different infrared colors by its precision spectrographs. In addition, its sensitive infrared detectors can detect extremely minute variations in the brightness of an object. NIRAS has the capability of detecting differences in color that are as small as 1/1000th of a micron, as well as differences in brightness that are as small as a few hundred parts per million. In addition, Webb is extremely stable, and its orbit places it around Lagrange Point 2, which is approximately 1 million miles away from the contaminating effects of the Earth's atmosphere. This allows for an uninterrupted view, as well as data that is clean and can be analyzed in a reasonable amount of time. What Webb has in store for the study of exoplanets is only hinted at by the exceptionally precise spectrum, which was created by simultaneously processing 280 distinct spectra taken during the observation. During the next year, scientists will employ spectroscopy to examine the surfaces and atmospheres of several dozen extrasolar planets. These planets range in composition from small rocky worlds to giants that are rich in gas and ice. Exoplanets and the materials that make them up are the focus of over one quarter of the observation time that Webb allots during Cycle 1 of its mission. This NIRAS observation reveals that Webb can characterize the atmospheres of exoplanets in precise detail, including the atmospheres of possibly habitable worlds. The JWST is widely regarded as the most advanced space observatory ever constructed. Webb will investigate the enigmatic architecture and origins of our cosmos, as well as our place in it, as well as solve mysteries that exist inside our solar system and look beyond to more distant worlds that orbit other stars. Webb is a multinational effort that is being led by NASA in collaboration with the European Space Agency and the Canadian Space Agency. The Science Mission Directorate is in charge of the mission, while NASA headquarters is in charge of overseeing it. The Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, which is operated by NASA and operates Webb on the agency's behalf, is in charge of supervising the work that the Space Telescope Science Institute and Northrop Grumman, together with other mission partners, do on the mission. In addition to the Goddard Space Flight Center, several other NASA centers such as the Johnson Space Center in Houston, the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California, the Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, the Ames Research Center in California Silicon Valley, and others, all made contributions to the project. Goddard was the lead center. Well, that's all we have got for today's video. Please do give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to know more cool stuff and updates like this. See you next time!